Hello and welcome back to Supercharged here in Mexico City. We're in one of the most populous cities in the world and also the most congested. Now, this road was so crowded that they decided to build another story directly above to double the flow of traffic.
That's where a citizen-led project called Via Verde comes in. Not so much to clean up the streets, but rather to green them up.
Via Verde is a project that will transform more than 1,000 concrete pillars of this elevated highway. So we'll get more than 60,000 square meters of new green area to Mexico City. The World Health Organization recommends around 9 square meters of green area per inhabitant. In Mexico, we have less than 4.
So not even half.
Not even half. So we're transforming every bridge, every pillar, every wall into new green areas to produce oxygen.
Doesn't it look great? And you can suddenly see how many different species of plant you've got.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad it's cleaning up the air here, because even just standing here, breathing in the air, you can feel the pollution going into your lungs,
yeah,
can't you?
Plants do a great job of absorbing carbon dioxide, pumping out oxygen, and improving air quality. But at a garage out of town, they're taking it one step further, converting existing gas-guzzling cars into brand new electric vehicles, one combustion engine at a time.
Check out this old Beetle, really popular in Mexico because they've actually been used for years as the taxis. Now, take a little look under the boot where the engine sits, an internal combustion engine pumping lots of dirty air into what is already a very polluted city. But if we have a look under here, we can already start to see the progress. Engine's been taken out, motor's going in, it's just waiting for the battery. Hector!
Hi.
What are you actually doing? Because clearly we're standing in front of this Peugeot, yeah, and there is one big hole where the engine used to be.
Yeah, yeah, it was a very, interesting car. It was polluting the environment. It was an old car, and we decided to put an electric motor and so the car is going to be completely free of pollution.
So as well as giving this car a completely new lease of life, you're actually taking a dirty car that is putting pollutants into the air off the road and putting a clean one on.
Yeah, sure.
Do you think other people are going to follow in your footsteps?
Yeah, absolutely. I believe this is a very interesting project because this is somehow much affordable for the people to get instead of buying a brand new electric car or any hybrid or an alternative car.
Now, some critics of the electric revolution worry about where the electricity comes from to charge these cars, and understandably so. If the electricity is generated from dirty fossil fuel power stations, then it kind of defeats the point.
So that's exactly why energy companies are investing in renewable sources of power. Clean energy for clean cars. It's the last piece in the puzzle of how to improve air quality in Mexico City.
I'm hoping you can help me answer this question.
Yep.
If I was to charge my electric vehicle in Mexico City, where would the electricity come from? And is any of that renewable?
The electricity will come from the grid. The grid gets the energy from all the generation plants of the country. Today, 28% of the capacity installed in Mexico is renewable.
Okay, that's a good start.
As you see here, this is Mexico, and this is the resume of our generation. Right now, we are generating 240 megawatts, more or less. That is, more or less, we are giving energy to 600,000 households
in
Mexico.
Okay.
So that's interesting. And then, we can get into details, so we can zoom in, and now we see our plants.
All the different wind farms.
Yeah.
We've been experiencing, you know, out on the roads today, obviously the pollution levels are very, very high in Mexico City. Do you think one of the keys to solving that problem is more people using renewable energy?
50% of the pollution of Mexico City depends on cars, on transportation.
Yeah.
And I think this is going to change dramatically in the next few years. Clearly, renewable is very important, but also it's very important electric vehicles.